Hello, hello students of class 8. Welcome to the online tutorial classes for Vidyavabhan High Secondary School. I am Megha ma'am and this video is for the life science and the chapter what I will continue today is the health and hygiene. It is the part 3 video. The last month I have already given you two videos from this chapter where the basic idea of the diseases and the communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases was there and also the differences of between the being healthy and being disease free was there, and also there are characteristics and some classifications of the non-communicable disease. Okay, so today I will start with the communicable disease. So here one main term that we have to know, that is pathogens. Okay, so what is a pathogen? The microorganisms that cause the communicable diseases like measles, malaria, dengue, chikungunya and AIDS, like this. Okay, so now by a chart we will discuss the name of the disease along with the causative agent of it and the mode of transmission, symptoms and prevention of it. So the first name of the disease, I will discuss. Next, the symptoms I will discuss, and then the prevention also I will discuss. Okay. In that way, the first is influenza. So the first is influenza. The name of the disease is influenza. Here it is a very common cough and cold problem, and it is a very common disease which is very communicable and usually seen in the common people. The causative agent name is myxovirus. Myxovirus means a group of viruses. Okay. So now the mode of transmission. The mode of transmission of influenza is the droplet infection through coughing, sneezing and spitting. That means if someone has influenza and he cough in front of you, then the influenza virus can come to you by the air. Okay, so by the droplets, by the water droplets, is usually transmitted one to another. So the mode of transmission will be droplets. So now, what are the symptoms which you usually have? The common symptoms are sudden fever with headache, sore throat, muscular pain, coughing and sneezing, etc. So symptoms are fever, sore throat, muscular pain, coughing, preventive measures that we should say are keep away from the infected person. That is the main thing. Then and also the cover your mouth and nose while coughing or sneezing.
So one is keep distance. Keep in distance with infected person. And the second is cover mouth while coughing or use mask. Mask is now very common for this coronavirus, but for influenza patients also, if they use the mask properly, and also the people who are going outside every day in the monsoon or in summer season, if they use this cover mouth, when they are coughing or sneezing, if they cover their mouth, then the influenza can be stopped. Next is measles. So the next one is measles. The causative agent is paramyxovirus. Okay, so it is the name of the causative agent, that is paramyxovirus. Now, what are the mode of the transmissions? It's also by the droplet infections, right? Droplets. Infection. And the symptoms is more or less like the influenza, but it also has some more infections, some more symptoms like first the sore throat, watery eyes. The main thing is small spot appears at the body, like rashes. Okay. This is the main thing, like sore throat, running nose, watery eyes, dry cough with fever are the common things. Also, small whitey spots appears on the inner walls of your cheek. Red rashes appear first in the neck region, then in the whole body. Within a week, the rashes fade away, leaves brown colored spot. So the measles spot is left after the person have from the measles. Okay, next, the prevention. The prevention is MMR vaccine. Okay, this vaccine given to children at age of 9 months and also in the 15 months. Okay, and the isolation of patient for 10 to 12 days is very much necessary. And the MMR vaccine is actually in the vaccination schedule, the immunization schedule. Okay, so today I have discussed about this influenza and measles in detail and also about the pathogens. In the next class, I will continue this part with some of new diseases. Till then, thank you.